Yo, what's going on, guys, and welcome to the JAMARI channel in 2021. I'm happy that you all made it into the new year, and hopefully this year will treat you a lot better than last year did for a lot of people out there. And I thought, what better way to ring in the new year than to drop a compilation of all my funniest roast, all my funniest jokes, all my favorite moments from all my videos I made last year in 2020, which is like 175 videos. Your boy was really out here on his grind. And you guys really showed me a lot of love and support last year. I gained a lot of new subscribers. I got a ton of views. So I'm really thankful for you guys, and I do look forward to entertaining you this year. But without further ado, here's the JAMARI Rewind 2020. I would never really want to go to Tennessee, aka wannabe Texas, in the first place. You ain't Texas, baby. Our women look like models, while yours look like dogfish. Michelle's only friend, on the other hand, seems to be that giant pimple on her dome piece. Talk about a volcano, that thing's about to erupt.
Okay, I just texted him. He's responding now.
So she says, hurry, we need to talk. Important. It's very important that you know your penis is very small, sir. And if a girl my age in her 20s has this in her apartment, you're smashing on the first night without a doubt. Just remember, guys, safe sex is great sex. You better wear latex, cause you don't want that latex that think I'm latex. How many licks to get to the center of that Tootsie Pop? Let me see that. It looks like a 1, a 2, a 3. A 3. I'll never get over that owl for being such an asshole to that little boy. And so what this dude pretty much does is prepares her some pretty patties. It looks so good on that nice little rainbow palette. I'm pretty sure this guy stayed up all night painting his toenails and dyeing these french fries. But yeah, like, she can't even eat the french fry when it's a different color. She literally starts crying from eating a blue french fry. Dr. Dow is just looking at her like, you weak.
What are you feeling right now by looking at that blue fry?
It looks like a dead blue finger.
And so one of the things they like to do with these pep rallies is get some poor Joe Schmo to dress up as the rival mascot from across town. I guess in this case they were the chickens. And oh, did this guy get absolutely clucked.
Hey, funny guy! I got a joke for you! What smells rotten and puts people to sleep?
Noxious gas?
No! Your act!
This is like some sort of weird nerd foreplay, like, oh my god, you're so knowledgeable. So every once in a while, I crack down and I let her take me to the downtown area of the city and try and feed me some expensive food that, quite frankly, looks like it's a meal for a fancy dog. You know, I'm the kind of creep that's, is he giving it to her right late night? You know, I need to know these things. Please don't tell me Skippy's about to shave a heart into his chest hair. Jesus Christ. He's out here looking like an unseasoned chicken. Slap some lemon pepper on him and throw him on the grill. This guy's done. I can say I'm pretty disgusted, but I'm also very intrigued how this is gonna turn out. There's absolutely nothing okay with 4 people using the same bathwater. The last time that people had hygiene habits this disgusting, there was a black plague. I think I'd rather be a rat in a New York sewer where homeless bums constantly piss and shit on me every 10 minutes than have to be a member of this family.
Getting up to 265 pounds, sporting 20-inch biceps, Dylan says he still never felt big enough.
Yet he does all of this stuff to be built like a well-fed pug. And no offense, but when you go to the mall and you dress like this, you deserve everything bad coming to you in life. Those right there are the socks of a serial killer. This man shouldn't be allowed within 400 feet of a playground. So that if someone is standing out there like the delivery man, for instance, you can tell them, hey, put that package right there, sonny boy. And no more personal deliveries inside this home with my wife while I'm out at work. I'm guessing it's slim pickings out there for the sugar daddies these days, when women like this are getting paid for their companionship. This chick looks like if Billie Eilish went to McDonald's for 3 months straight, slammed down nothing but Big Macs, got eaten alive by a snake, and then spit out. His ex-wife and 3 kids must just be so proud of grandpa over here. So with the current state of the planet, you know, no sports, channels like ESPN really don't know what to do or to even post about. Honestly, do they even have a real identity without sticks and balls? As it turns out, ESPN really ain't that different than your local OnlyFans girl. Hell, he was over 6 feet tall when he was only 6 years old. Can you imagine the immense pain this poor woman had to go to just to force him out of her cooter? Ethan Klein wants to be Howard Stern so bad, like, I'm pretty sure every single night this guy jacks his little wiener schnitzel to pictures of him and dreams about him sitting on his face and This woman is a whopping 26 years old, and by the looks of it, she's aged like some fine milk left out in the sun, with her candy corn teeth. And the special thing about this wedding is that this woman Annie is actually marrying her first cousin Josh.
Come on now, dawg. Come on, man.
How did you two meet, by the way? Well, we were up in the moon bounce at the family reunion, and it just kinda clicked. You know that old saying that four heads are better than one? Well, it's really not the case when you're dealing with four idiots.
The relationship could best be described by having Tori as the hub and all of us are spokes on a giant wheel.
Dude, what the fuck?
Here you'll see a bunch of kids from the 2020 graduating high school class acting like they went through two tours through Vietnam for this country, all because they have to stay home during their final semester of their senior year. The people over at TLC like to refer to this as a mixed weight relationship, but I like to call it interracial. Rusty really just wants to keep his wife as big as possible.
It's like, all right, you're in a grocery store and you got this little nectarine here, or you got this big juicy peach here. It's like, which one do you want? I want the peach, you know?
Nope. And as for her cousin, man, just trim the sideburns. If you trim those hedges, you'll be like a god to this inbred nation. You could be with Aunt Lisa with her two big old deformed titties. And am I the only one who thinks it's weird that he's basically sitting inside of her?
Are you comfortable?
I'm
pretty comfortable.
Are you?
Yeah.
Can you even imagine the heat radiating off that thing? It's like a Dutch oven up in there. Just standing there in his shitty homemade costume, sporing the weak-ass glasses over his candle wax mask.
Good luck.
Awesome.
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 Shut the f*** up!
And the fact that this man is turning down anyone who isn't sucking Gollum from the Lord of the Rings little wrinkled dick.
Do you like Lord of the Rings?
I do.
Who's your favorite character?
I like Legolas.
Mine is Gollum. Gollum is way better. I'm sorry.
He just has the biggest hard-on in the world for Gollum. All this guy really needs to do is go out to the local bingo hall and he'll find a couple of women who look just like the little f***.
I thought this was trick photography. I thought this was a midget. If I had never seen anything like this, nobody had ever seen anything like this.
Man, he was so strong that he made strong people look not strong. And it's time for Whitney, the beloved beluga herself, to meet the man who shot this urban cowboy out of his sack around 30 years ago. Right in this NASCAR-loving chubby chaser. Now that's the American dream. Can I get a Roll Tide amen? It was like they got a table of everyone who ate glue in elementary school and asked them to make a show, and this is what they came up with.
How fat would a dude have to be to stop a bullet? How long would it take to eat a horse? Can you bounce a quarter off a stripper's ass?
The stripper's ass is tight enough, you could totally bounce a quarter off that.
And look, to the people my age, all I'm saying is, if you had Tooth Tunes toothbrush, the gummy Flintstones vitamins, and never had to ride the bus growing up, you're soft, you're privileged, and you're coddled. I was chewing on school board chalk each morning on my way to school, and you didn't see me complaining.
And some of you music concierges might be asking about what it sounded like. And quite frankly, it sounded like it was coming out of Selena Gomez's asshole.
And I just have to say it, if this kid was any other color, he'd either be getting his ass kicked to the curb, or would simply just cease to exist. I know I would have slapped the shit out of this kid by now.
I asked you hours ago to clean up that mess.
What's going on?
And there's absolutely nothing intimidating about this Andy Milonakis looking motherfucker. His speech impediment makes him sound like he's 5 years old.
I am about to break your nose like again.
I don't really exercise. I don't hang out with friends outside or anything.
Damn, I wonder what that there on my TV screen would taste like. I wonder what it would be like to have that object, or person, or whatever it is, on my tongue. And now Nickelodeon, of all people, has decided to join the list with the latest news that our beloved Sponge, who lives under the sea in a f***ing pineapple, the guy who plays the damn piccolo on his nose, is gay. He's playing with a whole nother type of piccolo, guys. I just knew that he spent some crazy night under Patrick's rock. So this man is just on this show high out of his mind driving a woman around Midland, Texas, who was behind bars just hours ago. How crazy is that? He's about ready to bust a tsunami nut tonight after not hooking up with anyone besides his good old hand for the last 2.5 years. If you don't call that a drought, I really don't know what is. And you can just see it in this man's eyes that he's on a mission to see those beef curtains by the end of the night. So he's pretty much driving down there with a half chub pitching a tent in his pants.
What do you want to do after dinner?
Oh man.
All this?
I want all of your body, you know?
Well, now you're gonna get it every day, so.
The kid already has a punchable face, and by the end of the movie, I think that most of the audience can agree that it'd be a good idea for the little fucker to go play in traffic, and having some very strange relations with his cat.
Huh? Oh yeah, daddy likes.
These women are unstanding this man, who probably smells like Subway, at an alarming rate. This man was going in there on a mission every single day to beat his meat. I've seen about as much crazy stuff on there as I was seeing on Facebook back in 2012. Back when people were getting decapitated and
what the hell did you just say?
He basically wants to split the Democratic vote, or at least take enough votes away from the Democratic nominee Joe Biden. So apparently the bubonic plague is also called Black Death? You know, of all the diseases, of all the illnesses, just of all the things you can catch out here, Black Death is not something that I want. Okay, that sounds like a very aggressive disease. I know I'm gonna have a lot of people down in the comment section saying that, this is somehow me making fun of someone with a disability just because this guy has taken so many perks that he's just out of his mind. He's incoherent. Half the time you don't understand what he's saying. Like right here, watch this one.
Hey man, you know what they say? They say perk the goat. There's a lot of goats out there, but I'm the only one. The only one, nigga. Cat can't pet him. Cat can't pet him. Cat can't pet him. Cat can't pet him. Okay.
Like, can you get this special guy away from the goats?
Can I pet him?
So she tells me, nice hate video, dude. LOL. Well, nice sponsored Instagram post where your boyfriend, despite the color of his white skin, says the N-word over and over and over again.
They tell me go on, taste the bad, taste the bad. They tell me go on, taste the bad, taste the bad.
Battery low.
Seriously? Come on, charge your speaker, man. That boy had to stop his freestyle for...
battery low!
I really didn't want to do this, man, but... you kinda left me no choice. Rest in peace, Percocet. Yeah. I'm Michael Psycho, dancing on your grave like I was Michael. You say you wanna kill me, but I'll end your family psycho. I've been the man since rubber bands and push pop popsicles. I'll blow your fucking brains, then I'll leave your fucking body slope.
Your body slope?
Like that white your bitch was sniffing. Never really pure, they just whipped that in the kitchen. Now you in the hearse, oh my god, Jamari snitching. Am I really fucking snitching? Did I go and say too much? Your girl is so obsessed with me, please get off my nuts. She dissed me online, but in my DMs wanna fuck. Talking about I wanna leave him, let me show you how I suck.
Hey, do you really tell this guy that you wanna fuck him? Let's not talk about that right now, Perk. Alicia, I thought it was me and you for life, baby.
I thought you was gonna be here for my come up, you know, when I'm at the Grammys. I'm not gonna call you, baby. I'm not gonna call you. Fuck Jamari, man. Fuck that dude.
But this freak isn't even consuming his own urine. He likes to slurp down other dudes' pee.
Huh?
More specifically, the urine of young men.
Bro, what are you talking about, man? Bro, I'm out, man.
He's preparing to suck that sausage, okay? He's taking them deep breaths.
Nice.
Okay, so this is a little bit disturbing. I do have to say, viewer discretion might be advised here. I'm basically saying that I feel like Ellen is the ultimate Karen in disguise. So while I was editing this video, I found some pictures of Dan before he grew the beard. And Jesus Christ, I see why he keeps it. He looks terrible. He's like an in-shape Shane Dawson. The man was publicly the owner of one of the most famous magazines on the planet. He was kind of like Stan Lee, but with hoes. Besides this one dude, Mike, who I just can't stand. He's always going on and on about his past drug addiction and his P-star girlfriend. How many times do we gotta hear your justification as to why it's okay half the world saw your girl get piped by the Lifetime Fitness Rec League champions, buddy? Dan is actually the perfect role model for the fake it till you make it crowd of idiots who spend their $800 bi-weekly check on Gucci and a bottle of Henny to flex for the gram.
Fuck outta here, that site's tea, you bum-ass nigga!
It's not a-
yes it is!
Video. You're
OD'ing
right now, I'm trying to make a video!
All while their air mattress is still on the damn grounds in their apartment they haven't paid rent on in 3 months.
Give me rent.
You'll get your rent when you fix this damn door!
Some of you out there are actually such simps for this dude that you'd probably suck up his leftover nut off of some 17-year-old anorexic Instagram model's stomach. Good job, Brad. Have you incorporated pineapples into your diet lately? It's either that, or he's talking to some fat, smelly Russian guy behind a keyboard. It's basically the Simp Olympics going on over here in America at this point, my people. And after many, many, many attempts, the Super Simp finally gets it done.
Come and get it, come and get it.
Oh, Jesus Christ. Can I get a replay on that cringe, replay man? Oh my god, I can feel the secondhand embarrassment through the screen. He pulled out the Roach Stomper 4s to top off his entire terrible outfit. This leather on leather matching combo has my face cringing up in horror. How horny did he expect this Lindsay woman to be when she showed up that she was gonna wanna come home and bang an old man dressed like a greaser going to coach a college football game? This is logic in 10 years, man. This isn't the Navy, Lieutenant Douche Nozzle. Honestly, you'll be lucky if you don't catch these two smoking cigarettes in your room. They might fuck around and open up the wrong drawer and see the monster dild that your wife pegs you with every single night, sir. You see, before the internet was a thing, weirdos who thought like this would isolate themselves because they're not normal. But now due to the internet, they can kind of congregate like the homeless people in Austin and fuck everything up while being potentially dangerous. Now that was a good metaphor. Is it not unsettling to anyone else that this man literally saw her grow up and he was just waiting for his moment to pounce, like some type of horny lion? He saw her in those footy pajamas and now he's looking at her like this. What a sick fuck.
There's some holes in this house.
Yeah, it's pretty, it sounds good. He would ask the girls to all throw their bras on stage and play jump rope with their fucking training bras.
He did this in the concert?
During the concert. He thought it was funny.
I thought it was funny.
You can't tell if this dude is about to take a tour through Iraq or go into third period algebra when he's got one of these on.
Something to this movement of the load.
Oh yes, the movement of the load is very important, sir. Quite frankly, the backpack looks like it's fucking everyone who wears it from behind. Moving to the user's exact body movements. Ooh, this backpack's good. Is Tony the Tiger gonna get smoked next by a serial killer?
Oh, brother, this guy stinks!
I mean, what the fuck kind of campaign is this? You know no one bought this. This ain't drip. $10,000 for laundry. It costs about $10 a month to do laundry, bitch. She must have been lazy as fuck during this marriage if they were dropping $10,000 on laundry. And I just know someone's gonna be down in the comments.
Well, you know how expensive dry cleaning can be?
Shut the fuck up. And this thing looks like something straight out of a nightmare. I'm telling you, eventually it'll just be Elon and his sweet, sweet robots. You know, when I saw that one robot do a push-up, I knew we were in trouble. There was more braces in that place than an orthodontist's office on a Tuesday afternoon. It was straight up like a middle school dance up in there. I mean, check out this picture of me and one of my friends from high school in one of these Hoodie Allen crowds. What the fuck? Definitely wouldn't date a girl with OnlyFans. Just because I don't want everyone seeing my girl naked.
We wouldn't be like, this is the person I'm going to spend the rest of my life with.
In fact, their entire staff could make up one of those third-tier sororities they have on every college campus. You know, the one that has all the ugly chicks? Oh.
Say it with me, Jimmy. Black lives matter. Louder, Jimmy.
Black lives matter.
Louder, Jimmy. Say it so that Mike Pence can hear it.
Black lives matter.
Jesus Christ, that was hard to sit through. And the fact that there was no audience really exposed how cringy this all truly was. Somebody call 911. Why bitches always burning on the dance floor? Whoa. I remember like thinking, how do you act like such a bitch for like $12 an hour? It's just not worth it to be such a big bitch. She would drink the green Hawaiian punch every single day. We had a big ass thing of it in the break room. She would just take her big old green Hawaiian punch and fucking drink it in the morning with donuts.
Sipping on it.
At 5 in the morning. She'd be like, you don't want one? Nah, I'm good. I brought a pack of almonds. I swear some of these people just be sipping on that idiot juice. And let's be honest, those were bold words coming from a man whose ankle could snap walking to the fridge. Apparently, he never touched anyone besides himself, which is still gross. I knew his downfall was coming, and then he released this Big Day album. Ooh, I love my wife. I love my wife. Just the other day, these women of Twitter were sipping on straight idiot juice. We know there's many adults and minors alike using incognito. Parents step out for a minute, incognito. Wife steps out for a minute, incognito. They're looking at you through your camera, gripping that acorn with a stranglehold, Timmy. Oh yeah, she sees this big old black American man coming over here. He's nice with the kids. And she's like, oh, you want to go out and get some fish and chips and douche my Come on, Damien, douche my This guy in particular is an absolute idiot. Him and his go-go dancer mom seem to share a brain, and he's so far up her ass that she's about to have to push him out for the second time. If one day your own son was to get you pregnant, God forbid, that baby would come out with 5 legs and 3 eyes. That's the ultimate boss move, not showing up to your wife's 40th when you're beefing. This is a major failure to launch situation. It's time for the birdie to leave the nest. Please get off that breast milk diet, son. It's time for a fresh pair. Preferably something that wasn't shaken around in the 70s. But honestly, Scottie Pippen's ex Larsa dresses like a 20-year-old insta-whore, so this wasn't really surprising. Tall Bill Cosby over here just couldn't get the job done anymore for this hoe. Yes, it's true, Scottie couldn't drive her to the hole like he used to, but another man could. A man who also plays with orange balls for a living, and no, I'm not talking about Mike Pence. Dating! Oh my god, this has to have been years and years of incestual mating that went into making these two faces. Why are you gonna reward her bad behavior with a nice trip? And can you imagine if it blows up out there? You know, the worst thing ever is to be beefing with your significant other while you guys are on a trip together. Okay, it's just trash because you're supposed to be having a good time, and the whole time you're just thinking about this other coach, Cream Pioneer, with his full head of hair. Well, I never thought that it'd be so simple, but I find a way, I find a way. Accepting 150 students for an in-real-life college experience, and it's not really a college experience, it's just a big old hangout, you douchebags. She kept on sucking me, then prison boys started coaching her. Suck that dick. Oh, this is getting weird. He even put his hands on her hair and shoved her mouth down so she gagged on me. Oh my god. I don't think that what you're doing here is straight anymore at that point. You know, that's just my opinion. This expired Kardashian is getting tossed around the NBA so much that the Knicks basketball is going to be jealous of her next season.
Yo, what the fuck is wrong with y'all grown-ass men running around losing your minds over a PlayStation 5? Y'all are not that serious about doing nothing else. Y'all haven't been that serious about nothing or committed to nothing else.
Oh, so let me get this right. When the latest makeup palette drops, or when women are excited to spend $500 on a purse, that's perfectly fine, right? Or when someone spends $1,500 to go to the gym every year, how about the $600 it costs to go to a sporting event nowadays? Oh, fuck it, how about the $150 a lot of people spend going out every night? Just because you don't understand something doesn't mean it's childish or dumb. This chick must give some insane dome. Hitting them with that triple hands, you looking down like, where the fuck did that third hand come from?
Hey everybody, the white privilege is here. So Olivia, both your parents are in jail.
There is nothing he can do about this. There's a reason one of them got drafted third while the other is contemplating going to China. And last but not least, we have sister Jaden, who seems like she came straight out of the TikTok factory. And there's her with Scotty Jr. and other Scotty Jr. and Scottay Jr. And even walking out, this guy don't have any sense of responsibility.
And for me to be standing here right now, I want to rip out the beautiful hair in my head.
God, it's nice to see the mouth breathers of society lose.